Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Jacqueline. I make the videos every week, a whole variety of things, lifestyle, beauty, adventure, all sorts of fun stuff, and I upload every Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. And today I have a little bit of a different video for you guys. I'm gonna do a quick Colorado bucket list for us. A couple of the things we've already done, so I'm gonna hit those first. And then most of the stuff is gonna be around Colorado Springs, because that's where we're living. And then I do have like a few places I want to visit besides things that are in Colorado Springs. So I'm going to just hit those quickly last and just list a couple of places around Colorado I want to go. All right, so I'm also going to link Visit Colorado Springs website down below. Just a great resource. It's actually really user-friendly website. I find a lot of like visit whatever cities websites aren't super friendly to use. This one is really good. So I'm going to link that one down below. I'll leave links to anything else that I talk about that I can find. I have 14 links to different things, so I'll leave those all down below too in case you're curious about any of them. But let's just hop right in. So the first thing on my list was Garden of the Gods. I'll insert some footage here when we went. It was one of the first things we did and it was super fun. I have a whole video about it too, so I'll leave that in the corner and down below. But it's just a super fun kind of touristy thing to do, especially if you're doing like the main loop. They do also have a visitor center that has a little museum in it and stuff. I just think it's a great place for families and, you know, that kind of stuff. But it is also just beautiful, fun to walk around and see the different rock formations. If you're visiting Colorado Springs, I think it's something you should do. If you live here, I don't know how often you would actually go, but it is a cool place to go, and it's free to just go and park and walk around. But they do have guided tours and other sorts of educational things that you can pay for. So keep that in mind, but it is super fun. The other thing we already knocked off our bucket list was the Red Rock Canyon open space. It was so much fun, so pretty. It's a little bit less crowded than Gardens of the God, but it's still, we went early, and by the time we left around 10:30, 11, it was getting more crowded. So if you wanna go, I would suggest going early. But it was really fun. You can do all sorts of different things there. You can rock climb, ride horses, mountain bike, hike, all sorts of fun stuff. And again, there are some easier trails there, but you can also make it harder. I think you could spend probably a whole day exploring if you wanted to, but it is just really a beautiful place to go and see and to walk around and to hike. You'll probably get a theme here. There's a lot of hiking to be done. So the next thing would be a big one, which is Pikes Peak. So we live right near Pikes Peak. You can see it from everywhere in Colorado Springs. And there's a lot to do in and around Pikes Peak. Obviously you can hike to the top. It's one of the 14,000 foot mountains here in Colorado. So it's one of those things that you can like check off your bucket list. I'm pretty sure you can drive to the top. I know they're making a visitor center up at the top right now. So if you don't want to hike, you can still make it up to the top, I believe, by driving. But I just think it's one of those places that you have to visit, you know what I mean? So they do have a whole website about the Pikes Peak region as well as Pikes Peak itself and hiking and all that sort of stuff. So I just make sure you visit there first, make sure you have any passes or, you know, you're checking times for hiking and stuff. You wanna make sure, you know, you're following all of the rules and all that kind of stuff, and obviously following proper hiking etiquette and making sure the weather's okay, all that sort of stuff. So just make sure, you know, you check out the website before you go. There's also a winery up at Pikes Peak, which that sounds right up my alley. A winery on a mountain sounds great to me. So, you know, that's probably something I want to check out too. All right, the next place I want to go visit is Manitou, which is very close to Colorado Springs. It's actually like right near Gardens of the God and everything. But this just seems like a really interesting, cool old place to go visit. It has its own little like downtown area that looks adorable. But there's a couple of things within Manitou that I wanna go check out. First of all, it's the cliff dwellings. It just seems like a really cool, interesting thing. There are basically like homes built into the mountains, like old dwellings. And it just seems really cool. They do tours, there's a museum, you can go see, you know, see the history of it and all that stuff. And you do have to buy tickets, and all that kind of stuff. But it seems really cool, and some place that, like, if you have family coming in town, that this is somewhere I want to take them. There's also the Manitou Incline, which seems like something you want to work up to, because you gain over 2,000 feet in elevation in just 1 mile, and this is all steps, so that'll be a fun workout. But I feel like it's something you have to go, like, see and do if you're in the area. It looks like you do have to have reservations right now for it because of COVID-19, but yeah, it just seems like one of those things that, like, you live in the area, you want to say you've done at least once. I don't know. The next thing I'm really excited for, I don't know if you guys know this about us, but me and Matt love the zoos. I don't know, we just do. And the one here at the Cheney Mountain Zoo looks so cool. First of all, it's in, like, right at the base of all the mountains and stuff. So that's a really cool setting. But also they have all sorts of feeding things you can do. So you can go and feed giraffes, you can go feed elephants, you can go feed rhinoceros, all sorts of things. You do have to pay for the feedings, but that just seems so cool to me and something, like, I really, really want to do. They also have special, like, seasonal events. Like, they had a Boo at the Zoo for Halloween. They have Christmas lights, which I love zoo Christmas lights. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's, like, we used to go when I was a child in Toledo and, like, go see all of them, but we went to the ones in Tacoma too, and they were super fun, so I definitely want to go check out the ones here. Yeah, and just seems awesome, like a really cool zoo. And we just, I don't know what it is about zoos, but we love to go to the zoo wherever we, like, go to visit. The aquarium, we just love it. I don't know what it is, but we love going and seeing the animals. Also in that same area is the Cheney Mountain like park area. You can actually go walk around. There's a whole bunch of hiking trails, but there's tons of hiking. It says it has 28 miles of trails. There's designated ones for equestrians and dog users. You can bike, all sorts of different stuff, but you're in, like, on the base of the Cheney Mountain stuff. I believe you can get the top of Cheney Mountain too, or Cheyenne. I always say it wrong. I don't know what it is. I've probably been saying it wrong this whole time. Picnic areas, all sorts of fun stuff. It looks like you can do archery and stuff there, but I just think it looks like a really cool park area. And like I said, it's local, so you can walk around and do things and not be too far from, like, the main area of town. The next place is the Fine Arts Center in Colorado Springs. Obviously, I'm an artist. I love going to museums and seeing it. And the Fine Arts Center looks really cool and interesting. They also have classes that I would love to take a class or two. I think it's important as an artist to keep up with that kind of stuff. So hopefully there's, like, a screen printing class or something. That'd be awesome. Obviously right now with COVID, a lot of them are virtual. And some of them are already sold out and stuff like that. But I would still just love to go and see the museum as well. And it just looks really cool. It's actually at Colorado College, so it looks really cool and interesting, and I just love the art museum. Okay, the next area I want to go to, I don't have a web or a link for this or anything, but it's Old Colorado City. It's right near Colorado Springs, and again, it just looks like a really cute downtown area, lots of shopping and restaurants, and just looks like one of those areas that'd be fun to go and explore and see what kind of shops and local restaurants and stuff are down there. It just looks really cute, and I believe it's an old mining town, and just looks really cute and interesting, and I would love to go there. We probably will, because it's, like I said, it's close to downtown Colorado Springs. Just looks like another cute local little, like, downtown sort of area. The next place I want to go is Canyon City and the Royal Gorge. This looks really, really cool. You can go and hike it. Looks like there's a suspension bridge over the gorge, which seems awesome. Obviously, the fear of heights might not be the best thing because it's up very high above the gorge and the river, but it looks beautiful. There's all sorts of, again, Canyon City has a really cute downtown area for, you know, walking around and shopping and eating and stuff like that. But the actual gorge seems awesome. You can go and, like, hike through it. It looks like there's some different adventures. You can, looks like you can river raft, you can bike, there's a zip line, there's jeep tours, all sorts of stuff. There's also some museums in Canyon City. And just, like, a really cool, interesting place to visit. And it's kind of, looked like it was kind of like in between the mountains, which would be really pretty and cool too. And it just looks like a great place to go explore. The next one might not be for everybody, but it's for somebody who loves Christmas like I do. So this is called the North Pole. It's a Santa's workshop. So there's a whole place in Colorado Springs. It looks like it's basically like an amusement park and shopping center in one. So right now they have 4 rides open. There's a train and looks like a couple other like things in the sky. I don't know. But it's free to go in and like shop and eat and look around and stuff. You do have to pay for the rides. But I would just love to go and like Christmas shop there and get some new ornaments. And it just looks like a really interesting place. It's open all year round. So like I said, I think you have to really love Christmas. I'm sure it's more crowded like towards Christmas time, but I just really want to go and see it and see what they have to offer and like walk around. I just think it looks like a really interesting place and I love Christmas, so there you go. The next place I want to go is Cripple Creek. Again, this is a mining town. The downtown area looks really cute. There's a lot of casinos there, so if that's your thing, you know, maybe you want to go do that. But they also have like another like train system there that kind of takes you through the mountains and stuff, and you can get history of it. It looks like the train only runs through like the summer basically, which makes sense because Cripple Creek is kind of up a little bit higher in the mountains, so it's gonna get frost and stuff. You don't wanna be out in the, it looks like it's an open air train too, so you don't wanna be out there too long or whatever. But again, it looks like there's like hiking parks and different things you can go and do and explore in Cripple Creek. It looks like their claim to fame was there was a gold rush there. So yeah, it just looks like a little interesting, cute town that's not too far from Colorado Springs, which I think is awesome. All right, and then the last category is just places around Colorado that I want to go visit. So I have a couple places. Obviously, we want to go to Denver. It's a big city, not too far from here. It's about 50 minutes from Colorado Springs, so it's really not too bad. But definitely somewhere I want to go and stay for a weekend, explore, walk around, do different things. Obviously, I do more research before we go up there, but it just looks like a really cool place. And then obviously some mountain towns that we would love to go visit, like Vail, Breckenridge, Telluride, Aspen, all those kind of places, the kind of more like popular kind of mountain town sort of places. I would love to go see those kind of places, take a road trip, spend a weekend. I just think that'd be so much fun. And then obviously I would love to go to the Rocky Mountain National Park. I just think it's a cool thing to like check off national parks. We've been to Mount Rainier National Park, and we've been to a few others along the way. And I just would love to go to Rocky Mountain and just see it and hike around and do different things. So I think that'd be really fun. But yeah, that's on my bucket list from now. I'm sure it will change and grow and shrink and, you know, all that kind of stuff. Hopefully we'll be here for at least 3 years. So we have plenty of time to check things off. Yeah, hopefully that you guys enjoyed this video. If you have anywhere in Colorado that you think I should visit, please leave me a comment down below. I'm always looking for suggestions of places to go and things to do. We love to go out and explore. So let me know if you have any places that we should go. And subscribe if you want to join our little adventure family here. And yeah, I think that's it for this video. So I'll see you in my next adventure. Bye.